Seaside FM, Dawn Langstroth. God help me, I'm my mother's child. Great song from Dawn from our great CD. You know, we play it here all the time at Seaside. And I have somebody who probably enjoys that piece of music too, and I'm going to go to her in just a moment. But I want you to know that it's our fundraiser, 469-2096. The pledge lines are open. I know you're going to be busy in the next few minutes. You're going to be busy listening to an interview with someone who I think probably was singing along to that song. We say, well, good afternoon here. Good morning to you, Anne Murray in Florida. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Gail.
Were you singing along to Dawn?
I was. My little girl.
I know. It's amazing. And we love the CD, and we'll get to that. But I want to, okay. You know, you and I have been chatting a little bit off air. And, of course, I've been trying to follow you on Twitter. I'm not good at it, but it keeps me posted on your golf score. I think you shot an 81 not too long ago.
Yeah, last week I did. I'm my game's coming together, but it's, you know, it's a work in progress, but it's fun trying to get there. I'm just in paradise here.
Well, you know, we're loved to have your music, and we're all lamenting your retirement. But I do want to ask you the obvious straight off the bat. I think I know the answer. Are you tired of being retired yet?
Oh, absolutely not. No, I'm getting better and better at it every day. I play 3 or 4 golf games a week. I have a trainer twice a week. I'm staying fit. I swim. I walk. Having a lovely time, and I'm working on my charities. So
right, and that, you go ahead, Ed.
No, I was just going to say that. And that's something I'd like to talk to you about today, too.
Absolutely. And you know what? I got to tell you about this card. I did have a birthday recently. It was 39 again. I love the card. And I thought of you and all my friends and all the people I know in this age group. And the card says, birthdays are like golf. Forget the score and just keep swinging.
Yeah, there you go.
So that's a good
idea.
Yeah, now tell me, obviously, the best part of retirement, you love golf and all that, but what is the best part for you?
Well, I think the best part is not having that stress anymore of trying to perform and be all things to all people. And I worked pretty hard for a long time, and I was away. I was on the road a lot. It's nice to just be in one place for a while. But I think more than anything, it was that day-to-day stress of having to be on every single night. And that was tough. And to get rid of it. The hardest part about retirement is because I was so busy, it's taken me a while to adjust. And everybody will tell you that, you know, you have to learn to adjust and take longer to do the crossword. I didn't even have time to do crosswords before, but now I read books and do crosswords and Sudoku and all those things, having a lovely time. And every now and then I feel guilty that I'm not doing something else, but it doesn't last long.
Well, no. I wonder, you know, so many people retire and then they want to travel. Obviously, for you, you've done so much traveling that just being able to be in your two, well, you really have three lovely, mm-hmm. lovely places to be. And, you know, you're in Nova Scotia in the summer and Toronto and in Florida. So just being at home and having all that time, that must be something, what,
well,
40 years?
And
40 years.
And I do have a lot of people asking me to travel here and there, and I, that might be down the road somewhere. But right now, I don't want to pack a suitcase and go anywhere. I did it for 40 years, and so I've earned the right to stay put. So,
you have indeed. But do you miss the? I'm sure you miss the interaction a little bit with the people.
Well, I miss most of all? I miss the camaraderie I had my road family.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the guys in the band and the girls, and that's what I miss the most, because we were together a long, long time. Most of people were 25 years or more, And so, you know, those are the people I miss, but we're having a little reunion this summer, so that'll be fun.
And I think from what I follow on Twitter, you do get some people that drop in, spend a little time with you. So you're keeping in touch with some of your dear, dear friends.
Oh, absolutely. And I'm in touch with people all the time, and I stay in touch with the fans on Twitter. And
well, you do.
And I'm enjoying it. It's fun.
The last question on the career that you want to stay retired, but even Frank Cameron the other day, Frank, of course, is here and a good friend of yours, and I heard Frank play a song by you, and then he said, I think there'll be a new CD coming out from Ann soon. I thought, does he have sort of like intel that we don't know?
He doesn't have a clue. No, there'll be no new CDs. There'll be no singing in public. There'll be none of that. The only thing I do now in public... The only thing I'll do is happy birthday.
Oh, okay.
That's the only thing I ever sing at all now in these days. I have been finding myself singing in the shower lately, so I might be singing again just for my own pleasure, but I haven't sung a note except for happy birthday in about 3 years.
But never say never.
I'd be afraid to even try to sing now.
But listen, Glenn Campbell, we play his latest CD, and sounds in great voice. Ken Tobias, a great new CD. Shirley Eichardt, I mentioned these people because they're all part of your career.
Yes, they are.
And they're still
well,
going.
Well, God love them. I mean, I see Glenn. Glenn, he'll be picking and singing as he's dying, you know what I mean? He's the kind of guy that it's so much a part of his life that I can't even imagine him ever giving it up. But for me, I had to. It was time.
You're very happy with that. And as you said, you've got a couple of things, because I would keep you on the phone forever, but I know do you have a golf game coming up today?
Not today. Okay. I just came back from my trainer. I do play golf tomorrow on Saturday.
I suppose as a true Maritimer, I should have said, how's the weather down there?
Oh, boy. It's just glorious.
Never mind that. Sorry I asked. But listen, I want to talk about a couple of other things. I want to talk about your charitable golf. You do a lot of charitable work, but you have this big golf tournament coming up. And I know a lot of golfers, and I bet you that they would be liking to attend this because it's, coming up in Markham, Ontario?
Markham at Angus Glen on May 17th, and it's... It's in support of Colon Cancer Canada. And by the way, March is Colon Cancer Awareness Month, and I'm trying to, my mission is to get people to get tested. And colon cancer, I was looking to kind of align myself with somebody who needed my profile, and they really did need me, so... some of the other organizations don't. And also, it's hard to get people talking about their butts, you know?
That's right.
So it's not exactly glamorous, but it's very important that we impress upon people they get tested. I mean, this year alone, 22,000 people will be diagnosed with colon cancer, and almost half of those people will die, and it's unnecessary. So it's my mission to get as many people as possible to get out and get tested because, you know, if you do and catch it early, it's 95%.
That's the thing. As you said, it's that willingness, and you raise the profile, and the willingness to go and be tested, because people are embarrassed, they're shy. And I know that the charity is one that you looked around, but you've been touched by losing some loved ones and dear friends to colon cancer.
Yes, my manager Leonard Rambo, who grew up in Dartmouth, died of colon cancer, and I also. At a young age.
Mm-hmm, very young.
And that was heartbreaking to lose him. And my grandmother was actually a colon cancer survivor in the 50s, in the 1950s.
Wow.
And so I have a family history of it as well. So I was tested at 40, and I've had, I don't know how many since then, probably three more since then, and people, I think, are nervous about the test, but it's, I just found it a cakewalk.
I went through it some years ago, and I think the fear of it is worse than the test.
Test is nothing at all, but so anyway, that's my mission, to get as many people as I can to get tested, and
You've raised a lot of money with the golf tournament, and I see here Brian Williams, Seamus O'Regan, Jeff Hutchison, all very, very prominent people, Canada AM, CTV. We all know Brian from Live.
The Olympics.
The Olympics. Yeah. And Marlene Street, fabulous golfer.
Oh, yeah.
She's part of this.
Yeah, Marlene, I just called her the other day. She's going to be doing it. Marlene is the first Canadian inducted into the World Hall of Fame and probably the greatest woman amateur golfer in history.
And she stayed amateur. She did.
Yeah, she did stay amateur. For some reason, I've never asked her that, but I play golf with her next week. Boy, that's a treat. She shot a 73 on her 77th birthday.
Go away.
Can you imagine?
I shot a 73 once, but it was a 9-hole course.
Yeah, 9. Yeah, we have Bobby Orr's coming, too.
I noticed that, and I know you've done a lot of different things, charitable things with Bobby Orr. And
yeah.
A great guy. Now, I know you're a diehard Leaf fan, but you love Bobby Orr, too.
Oh, I love Bobby Orr. I'm a hockey fan.
Yes.
I know. I watched Vancouver Canucks last night beat Detroit.
Can you get the hockey down there?
Oh, I get. Are you kidding? It's great. Nothing like hearing the crashing of the waves and watching hockey. It's awesome.
Yeah, and sipping on a little beverage, perhaps.
Maybe.
And listen, you're Leafs. Are they going to make the playoffs?
Oof, I don't know. I think it might take divine intervention. But we'll see. I've got my fingers crossed. I'd love to see them. They're a young team, and anyway, I'm always the fan. I'll be a fan to the end.
And of course, I'm a Habs fan, so we'll leave that topic right away.
Well, listen, I'm rooting for the Vancouver Canucks. Are you kidding? They're an awesome team.
Yeah, and a great Canadian team. And I know you're a big fan of Sidney Crosby's too.
Oh yeah, poor Sid.
Yeah, we got to get
wherever
him back.
Wherever he is,
I think he's
poor Sid. I mean, I feel so bad for him.
Well, we hear good reports that he's back on the ice. But your golf tournament, $400 per player, that's nothing. I mean, I've been in tournaments around here for almost that much. It's Tuesday, May 17th. Angus Glen is a double course, and you'll be there swinging.
I will.
All kinds of people. And I have a website that actually it's the Colon Cancer Canada website for people who want to maybe sign up or get more information.
Great.
And
well,
you're welcome, my dear. We'll also promote that. And I can't let you go without two more questions. The terrific donation that you've given us, and we've got it as our daily prize today, for the audio, All of Me. I read the book, of course.
All right.
Enjoyed it. And remember, my husband's mother's from Spring Hills, of the Caulfield.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Yes, of course he is.
So it was great to read a lot of that. And you spent, 8 days doing this? The audio?
8 days doing the audio book, I narrated it myself because I figured, if it's going to be told, it should be told by me. So, it was hard work.
And was it hard, even though you had already written the book, was it hard then actually talking about yourself and actually saying those words?
Well, it's more like acting.
Yes, it would be.
Because it's, as you're reading it, and the problem with it is, it's the written word, so it doesn't always roll off your tongue comfortably.
True.
It's meant to be read, not necessarily out loud. So I found myself tripping over words and tongues, and it's not conversational, if you know what I mean. And so it was hard work. And after about 3 hours, I had to stop. I could just do about 3 hours at a time because it was. Anyway, I couldn't do any more.
You could have turned it into a musical and sung it.
By that time, I wasn't singing anymore.
Darn. Last question. We started or went into this interview with Dawn's song, Lord Knows, or whatever, I'm My Mother's Child.
God help me. Mother's Child, yeah.
A wonderful CD, and now she's in the business, and I would presume you're happy.
Well, she's sort of dabbling in the business. I'm not sure that that's what she's going to do. She's a very talented artist.
She's written a lot of these songs.
Yeah, but she's a visual artist. She paints.
Ooh.
She paints in acrylics.
Terrific.
And you should check out her website. She's got some great paintings. Anyway, I think she might just be going to be a painter.
Well,
nice to have two talents, isn't it?
I know.
Nice to be that talented. She's very, very creative and could do one or the other. It's just the music business is not in very good shape right now.
So. No, it is tough. It really is.
Yeah, it's very tough. Everybody's in the business and doing albums in their basements, and there's so much stuff out there. And the music business is, poof, sad shape. I'm very happy that I was able to do it when I did it.
Well, you know, here we will have to get you to listen from time to time. I know some of your friends are very big listeners and supporters, and they listen to us on the web when they do go to Florida and elsewhere. And you check us out, because I think you'd enjoy the fact that we're easy listening from both yesterday and today, and we love to support the East Coast artists. We've got them all here. People, even some, you know, that were behind the scenes have come out. Kim Dunn, he's got a great CD, and Dave Carroll and Don Carroll, the Sons of Maxwell, and of course the ones you know so well, the Rankins and Rita, and Kenny Tobias, his new CD. And you know, we're doing our part. I think that's what we're, a community, not for profit station. I'm volunteering in here 2 days a week, and Frank Cameron, Paul Kennedy, and many, many others. And the joy is playing not just the old, you know, the oldies and the old hits, but playing the Michael Bublé's and the Diana Krall's and the Anne Murray's and the Dawn Langs.
Well, good for you. Yeah, so, that's a wonderful thing. It's nice to see the East Coast talent being promoted.
And when you get home, I'm going to keep bugging you. I have a few friends who play golf with you down that. You know, sure.
There you go.
And I'm going to get them to drag in here someday as a surprise guest into our studios.
Okay, I thought you were going to say you wanted to come and play golf.
Oh well, Helen, a mutual friend of ours, and I won't say her last name. She keeps telling me that I have to come down and play, and I said, I don't know if Anne will be very tolerant of my score.
Oh, I don't care.
All right, I'll see you this summer.
All right, good.
Well, look, we really appreciate it here at Seaside, and we'll all keep working on you to maybe you'll go back in the studio in 5 years. Never say never.
Sure.
Sure. All the best, Dan Murray.
Okay, thanks, Gail.
And all the best to Dawn, too. Tell her she's welcome to pop in anytime as well.
I'll do that.
Take it easy.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye.